This is AASHTO R75, developing a family of curves. We're presented here with tabulated Proctor data. On the far left column, we see individual Proctor methods identified with curve ID numbers. And then to the right of these, we have individual moisture and density points. And all of these moisture density points define individual curves. In order to develop a family of curves for these individual Proctor curves, we have to remember the rules for a family of curves. The first rule is we need at least three curves to fit on a spine in order to define a family of curves. The second rule is that all of the curves on a family of curves must be pounded with the same Proctor methods. In other words, all of the curves must be a T99A, or all of the curves must be a T180C, etc. So if we look at our tabulated data here, again in the far left column, Proctor method and curve ID, we see that the only Proctor method listed here that we have at least three or more curves is T99A. So all the T99Bs, T99Cs, T99Ds, we can cross out. We do not have three or more curves, so we cannot use those for a family of curves, and we can eliminate that data. So now we're only concerned with the T99As. To develop a family of curves with the T99As, in the middle of our table, we see points for maximum dry density and optimal moisture content. This is where we are going to start. We're going to take the maximum dry density and optimal moisture content for each of the T99A Proctor curves and plot those on a graph. So curve number one, we have 114.8 at 13.9. Curve number two, 114.7 at 11.2. Curve number five, 113.3 at 11.8. Curve number seven, 112.2 at 12.5. Curve number eight, 112.6 at 13.7. Curve number 10, 111.2 at 11.4. And curve number 11, 110.6 at 14.0. So we're going to plot these points on a graph, and that is shown here. The next step is to develop the spine of a family of curves. The spine is a best fit concave up curve that connects as many of the optimum moisture and maximum dry densities of the Proctor curves. Those that fit on the spine will define our family of curves. Those that do not fit on the spine, we have to remove from the graph. So those that fit are curve number two, curve number five, curve number seven, and curve number 11. And again, these are all pounded by T99A. So those that did not fit on the spine, again, we can go back to our tabulated data and remove those. So we can get rid of T99A, curve number one. We can get rid of curve number eight and curve number 10. So we're left with curve number two, number five, number seven, and number 11 that fit on our spine. So the next step to define our family of curves is we have to plot each individual curve that fits on the spine, but we're only concerned with the dry side, those Proctor points that are dry of optimal moisture. So for curve number two, we will plot these three points on the dry side of optimal moisture content and connect those to draw that Proctor curve. We'll do the same for curve number five, curve number seven, and curve number 11. So we plot each of these points for the respective curves and draw each respective curve that fits on the spine. And this is what we end up with. Now we calculate 80% of optimal moisture for each curve. So for curve number two, optimal moisture is 11.2. We multiply that by 0.8 and we get 9.0. Curve number 5, optimum moisture is 11.8. We multiply that by 0.8 and we get 9.4%. Curve number 7, optimum moisture is 12.5. We multiply that by 0.8 to get 10.0. And curve number 11, optimum moisture is 14.0. We multiply that by 0.8 to get 11.2. We then plot those 80% of optimum moisture on the respective curves. And the final step to develop the family of curves is to connect those points of 80% of optimum to establish our 80% line. This is the procedure for drawing a family of curves. You'll be expected to do this in your practical examinations when you come in to certify.